Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Labiha Aisha, Junior Resident, Department of Radio Diagnosis in MJ Medical College and Hospital, Navi Mumbai, presenting a case series on neuronal migration disorders and overview under the guidance of Dr. Ashutosh Chitnis. Neuronal migration disorders are a group of disorders caused by insults to migrating neuroblasts during the 3rd to 5th month of gestational age, resulting in developmental delays, seizures, and abnormal motor skills. In this study, we reviewed the salient features of these anomalies, their MR appearances, relationship of pathologic anatomy, and theories of pathogenesis. Aim of the study is to study the utility of MRI as a method of imaging to diagnose patients with neuronal migration disorders, and our objectives are to study the characteristics and salient features of neuronal migration disorders and their appearances on MRI, and to differentiate these disorders from each other on the basis of ability of MRI to exceptionally differentiate gray and white matter, and to study the relationship between pathologic anatomies of these disorders and their theories of pathogenesis. This is a retrospective study done in MGM Medical College and Hospital, Navi Mumbai. In a review of 300 MR studies in the pediatric age group, three patients with migration anomalies were identified. Patients presenting with seizures, developmental delay, or mental retardation were referred for imaging, and the patients' ages ranged from 5 years to 20 years. All patients were scanned on Toshiba 1.5 Tesla MRI machine. Migration anomalies were diagnosed from the characteristic MR morphology of the affected brains. This case series includes three cases consisting of one case of lesencephaly, one case of schizencephaly, and one case of porencephaly. Case number one, a six-year-old male patient presented with complaints of seizures and developmental delay. Here is the T2 axial image of the MRI brain showing diffuse thickening and broadening of gyri with shallow sulci, involving the right hemisphere, showing poor differentiation of subcortical white matter and mild paucity of underlying white matter. Here also, the T1 sagittal image showing diffuse thickening and broadening of gyri with shallow sulci. This is the characteristic appearance of lesencephaly pachygyria spectrum. Now moving to case number 2, a 5-year-old female patient came with complaint of spastic hemiplegia, seizures, and developmental delay. Here is the T1, T2 axial image of the MRI. There is evidence of cleft following CSF intensity with focal pointed nipple-like outpouching extending from ependymoma of body of right lateral ventricle up to the pial cortical surface of right parietal lobe. The lips of cleft are closely opposed with dysplastic heterotopic gray matter lining the cleft on either side. There is absence of septum pellucidum. However, corpus callosum appears normal. Here also the T1 sagittal image showing the cleft and corpus callosum appearing normal. This is the characteristic appearance of closed lip unilateral schizencephaly. Now moving to case number 3, a 20-year-old male patient presented with history of seizures, inappropriate behavior, and mental retardation. T1, T2 axial image of MRI showing CSF signal intensity cystic lesion in left temporal lobe, which is seen to be communicating with adjacent subarachnoid space surrounding encephalomalacia noted involving left parieto occipito temporal region. T1 sagittal image showing the cystic lesion lined by encephalomalacia. This is the characteristic appearance of porencephaly involving the left temporal lobe. The normal cerebral cortex is 6 layers consisting of marginal layer, external granular layer, external pyramidal layer, internal granular, internal pyramidal, and fusiform layer. Cerebral cortex develops in 3 stages: proliferation, migration of neuronal fibroblasts along the process of radial glia, and post-migrational development. Cells resulting from abnormal proliferation often neither migrate nor organize properly. And the abnormalities of neuronal migration disorders are characterized by ectopic location of neurons in the cerebral cortex. And these conditions are associated with intractable epilepsy, major psychomotor developmental disorders. The common underlying feature of migration abnormalities is abnormal location of neurons and thickened cortex by a large disorganized layer of neurons, and subcortical white matter layer is thin because of the absence of post-migrational organization. And the faulty cytodifferentiation and programmed cell death play important roles in generation of dysplasias. Lesenkephaly consists of 4-layered cerebral cortex instead of normal 6-layered cortex. There is the cell sparse zone, which is the area of laminar necrosis secondary to metabolic insult during migration phase. And degeneration occurs in the neurons that have already migrated but have their axonal and dendritic connections interrupted within the layer of necrosis. The subcortical white matter is thin because the organizing neurons with established dendritic and axonal connections are markedly reduced. Schizencephaly consists of bilateral or unilateral full thickness clefts of cerebral hemisphere. Pathologically, these clefts are characterized by an infolding of cortical gray matter along the cleft with a fusion of pile lining of brain and the ependymion of ventricles. And the clefts are lined by dysplastic gray matter. Porencephaly is the presence of intracerebral fluid-filled cyst within the CSF lined by white matter. Now the conclusion. Recognition of neuronal migration disorders depend on awareness of the characteristic appearance of the entities and use of proper imaging technique. MRI remains the best investigation to identify the anomalies of neuronal migration because of its exceptional ability of better differentiation of gray matter from white matter, and more sensitive in detecting schizencephaly, where recognizing the presence of gray matter lining the cleft is critical to differentiate it from porencephaly, which is lined by white matter. And in detecting pachygyria, where critical details of cortical architecture are obscured on CT due to overlying bone, MRI should be primary mode of investigation in infants presenting with seizures and developmental delay. And lastly, the references.